flowing in the forms of thoughts, deeds, actions, sounds, and other various inhibitions of the environmental surroundings that should do that. I have given 5 lectures in gynecology, in advanced gynecology, in obstetrics, and I have given a very clear definition that any person, I am not against dual economy, that is husband and wife both earning, because dual economy, triple economy, mixed economy, underground economy, you can develop any number of economical sources. But what I want is, if somebody is pregnant, she is having a more vigilant and substantially significant job of processing a creature to the fullest more, which cannot be done by anybody else. And according to me, pregnancy time should not be dedicated for any official functions or domestic liabilities or more hard responsibilities. So whenever somebody drives a vehicle, the suspension, the shock, and the various other things that they experience in the atmospheric stress, environmental stress, and organizational stress in their companies, that will affect the processing system. No doubt your full biological baby will be there, but the complete growth what you can be is the intellectual growth, the spiritual growth of the person. You can get your full structure if you are not delivering the mantras, if you are not delivering your pujas and other modes of worship. You may not be getting a son without one eye or one leg. It will be complete biologically, but not ontologically and systematically. That's what I told in the gynecological lecture. So garbhopatesha is recently, now they have found out in Algeria University that the children can learn music and relish music even at the age of the ungrown fetus of 3 months. It can imbibe and respond to that by its stimulus. So lack of things are there in cognitive technology. Now they are trying to observe. Number one, garbhopatesha at the time of garbha. Second thing, lack of samskaras are there even after the growth. And third thing, getting knowledge by parivartana. Just as I can give this to him. Like that, jnana can also be given to somebody else. Yes, I have given that knowledge. From today, from this second, let you start that. So jnana parivartana is possible. That is instantaneous, immediate, effective transmission of knowledge is possible. That is parivartana. By kataksha. Not by hard work, by sparsha, by touching, by vikshana, by seeing, by smarana, by thought, by ashraya, by association, by anugraha, by a merciful, bountiful shower, a person can be made as a good, knowledgeable person. It is known as ashraya, and these things come under kataksha. And by means of swatantra, a person who is born in a good family, having good samskara, they can also get that paramparagata, inherited by the ancestors, that also we can get. Where we are very much abundant with BP, sugar and everything inherited like that. There are also rarer than the rarest possibilities of getting at least a droplet of knowledge from our ancestors. We are not good receptives. You see, somebody told why my father has given only this, why he has not given his knowledge and capability. I told that he has given you both, but you have only adaptability for this. That is the problem of your adaptability and eligibility. So by kataksha we can get that. How to develop these things? Number one, rasayana. Now recently, the US Council for Research and Study of Complementary and Alternative Systems of Medicine, they approved that Brahmi, Ashwagandha, Vitania somnifera, Avena sativa, Azad directa indica, there are 2 or 3 species, they have researched and found out medhya rasayanas are possible. Those rasayanas like Brahmi Krita, made out of Brahmi, they are proper, resourceful, enriching agents of a person's natural synaptic pruning of brain to understand things, to produce more lubrication without giving disturbance for a person's continuous research and task analysis, as well as depressing or suppressing the rise of even the various irritants which are there due to mismanagement of our food and culture. So that can suppress these irritants and that can compress and boost the set of lubricators that we are about to get from the nature, but we are being totally disappointed. So these type of medhya rasayanas we should follow with our people. Second thing is mantropadesha. By means of mantras, practicing that, we can get that. Third thing is tapasya. Even without mantras, you have to sit silently. Anybody can say in a lecture, sit silently. Can we sit silently? Can I sit silently? Not like that. But today, what I have to say is, it is by practice, abhyasa and vairagya. You just try to sit for at least 5 minutes. There are 3 things. Immediately the people, they want to sit and master everything. Crash course. It is not like that. You must take it by time to time. Number two, you must be having good patience. Number three, you must be having good confidence. Number one, from today, every day, at least 5 minutes, you have to be silent. Not at the time of my telephonic call or personal visit to your place. In the pretext of my own injection, you must not make me disappointed. So take 5 minutes and sit quietly. At that time, your mind may be so wavering, it will not come in one day. Make it twice, thrice. Make it practicable for 1 month. At least after 1 month, you can have 2 minutes of patience. then gradually this 2 minutes without getting anything, getting something, the something will become everything, the everything can be concluded and confirmed with anything. So start with something from nothing, make this something everything, and that everything can give you anything. So this is the process. So everywhere the tapasya says, you don't think about anything, or you think about nothing, and sit in a place. When you make your mind evacuated, when you make your mind placid, at that time, the natural susceptibility of the mind and sustainability of the mind, that will work more. Then you will be having, even though you are not thinking about wisdom, if you are giving a vacuum evacuation of your mind, wherein by it is, because mind need not be given something known as wisdom. Mind is already inbuilt with wisdom, because intellect is a part of the mind. So you give an evacuation, you give a mass exodus to all of the impressions inside your mind for a limited droplets of minutes, so that gradually you can get all of these benefits. Cognitive technology, there are doing lot of researchers in the Southern California University and Central University of Florida. They are doing lot of research how to make assertion of your people study, PUPAL, people study, and how to make teaching and training, how to make automative teaching and training, how to create e-classroom, how to frame the syllabus, how to make phobic erosion, chemophobia in chemistry, biophobia in biology, physiophobia in physics, arithmophobia in mathematics, how to avoid all of these things, phobic erosion, maniacal cultivation, inculcation, concentration boosting. Now they have developed CogniFit. There is a new software known as CogniFit to install cognitive fitness into the people. Even to love your parents, or even to love your wife and children, they will be developing cognitive love after 5 or 6 years. So what is now human technology? We have everything inside, and seeking the guidance of technology which we have created for our own internal natural boost is a shameful offense. That too for Indians having a lot of cultural advancement and civilization advancement, it is nothing but a shell in disguise which is there in the form of a sophisticated technology. So concluding this session, I want to chant some mantras which we can follow, removing all of your chappals and shoes. Then I think that we can develop these things as a continuous series of lectures. Number one, what I want to say is, whatever we have studied now or discussed now, we must continue this as a web discussion. We must create this same group of educational institutions. I don't know remember the name. South Indian Education. SIES. It can be a systemic intellect emancipation system, SIES, in a different term. So I request and beseech everybody to immediately start a discussion forum for life management, in which I can answer, I can ask questions, you can answer, you can ask questions. So create a discussion platform in the cyberspace, number one. Number two, instead of creating this type of limited environment for a limited time scale, if we create an opportunity for 2 days for intensive discussion as a spiritual retreat, in which we casually hear music, some humor, some sort of cultural activities, some sort of recitation, some games and sports, some stotra recitation, some havans. So if it will be a multi-pluralistic dimensional presentation of the same knowledge for our intentional adaptability, then it will be more deep penetrating, number two. And number three, prepare a syllabus. And fourth, I want to very proudly and humbly announce that I never used to accept any honorarium anywhere for any speech. So whatever that has been given already by the Shanmugananda Sabha, inclusive of the flight charges, it has been added with 4,000 rupees and worth 40,000 rupees. I have been printing 2,500 copies of life management lecture, which I am going to distribute in the next session, or I am going to distribute to the president, which will be distributed to everybody who is present and who is a member of Shanmugananda Sabha.